Good evening. Thanks for staying with us. I'm Todd McDermott.
And I'm Tiffany Kenny. Let's get straight to Chris Emma. He's live in Stewart to explain the trouble with those tinted windows. Chris?
Yeah, Tiffany and Todd, we're standing right along Canner Highway in Stewart. And just behind me, you can see it's an exit area for I-95, and that is the area that the Martin County Sheriff says that he wants to defend. He described it as a two-pronged attack. Stop illegally tinted windows and put a stop to a burglary problem that has plagued Martin County.
Point them in there where those deputies are.
It's a crackdown in Martin County.
14%.
Drivers must have the proper tinted window percentages on their windows.
The issue is that it's for officer safety, for one thing. I mean, we get up on a car, we don't know who's in the car. You can't see who's in the car. That's a very dangerous situation.
The rule is 28% visibility on the front driver's side and passenger side windows, and 15% for the rear windows. Drivers were stopped to be checked.
You need to be able to see, and they need to be able to see you.
It's okay.
They need to see what's going on, I guess.
But the Martin County Sheriff, William Snyder, says it's not just to stop illegally tinted windows.
We want the pillowcase burglars to know that we're watching these exits off the interstate.
It's a problem that has plagued Martin County for months, pillowcase burglars. And this is part of the sheriff's strategy. He says they know the burglars drive dark tinted windows.
We have unmarked cars throughout the county. We have our traffic units diverted to looking for pillowcase burglars.
Expect to see a whole lot of this in Martin County.
We'll be stopping cars with dark tinted windows with the expressed intent of catching them.
Now, we were along one of those checkpoints all morning this morning, and it was really a mixed bag of people who got pulled over. Some said that they needed it. Some say that it was unfair to be pulled over. Well, the Martin County Sheriff said that during those town meetings that it was expressed to him that that's what people wanted. Now, if you do get a ticket for that tinted window, it is a one-time thing. It's your first offense. What you will get is a $113 fine and a non-moving violation. Reporting live from Stewart, Chris Emma, WPBF 25 News.